In this video, we'll animate our 2D rigged character inside Unity. We'll be creating both an idle and a run animation using the rig we set up in the last video. This is part 3 of a 4-part series where we draw, rig, animate, and finally build a reusable 2D character controller template. But I want to be upfront. This isn't a polished, hyper-edited animation tutorial. You won't see perfect poses or textbook breakdowns. Instead, you'll see something more real. A lot of this video is just me saying things like rotate it like this or move this here. That's what animation often is. It's small tweaks, trial and error, and moments of silence. I didn't want to cut that out. Because if you're learning animation, you need to see how imperfect and human the process actually is. Okay? Let's get started. In order to start animating the character, we need to go to the animation window. We can do that by going to Window, Animation, Animation. And I've docked it over here. I recommend creating a new folder called Animations. Then go back to the animation window, select the root of the prefab, hit Create, and then head over to the new animations folder, and let's name this animation player idle. There we go. Now if you go back to the project window, Unity has created an animation file and an animator controller. If we click on the root, you can see that an animator component has been added, which has the controller of 2D character. To make sure that it is applied to the prefab, you click on overrides and then apply all. By the way, if you want to see the bones, you can click on this icon here. And if you select the character, you can see the bones. Now, typically this would be the best time to add IK, inverse kinematics. Inverse kinematics helps a lot in procedural movement or procedural animation and helps us with movement. Because we're creating a template, I recommend not sticking to it. Typically we use forward kinematics, which means if you rotate one bone, all of the child bones also get rotated based on the parent bone. In inverse kinematics, it's the inverse. We rotate the child bone or move the child, and then the parent will also move appropriately. And in order to do that, we need to use mathematics and constraints. But Unity has provided the code for all of it, and it's easy to set up. If you want me to do a video on IK, and trust me, it is not going to be a simple 10-minute tutorial. If I have to be honest, IK takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of patience, it takes a lot of weight painting, because things will go wrong in IK. Any other tutorial that is just 10 minutes long has either been rehearsed or is not teaching you the consequences of using IK. So if you want to add IK to your 2D rig, now is the best time because we haven't started animating yet. So let's go back to animation. And let's make sure that player idle is selected. Now let's create our idle animation. Firstly, let me move the player to an appropriate position. I think, yeah, something like this would be fine for an idle animation. Then we go to the animation window and click on this record icon. And this is the very first frame. As you can see, the frame number is 0. And we just move and it automatically adds keyframes to whatever we change. Okay, we are currently changing the rotation of the upper leg R, and you can see a keyframes for upper leg R rotation has been added. Let's make sure to move the lower leg R as well. You can something like this. This is why having a platform is great. Now you know the legs are perfectly placed. I'll move the hands a little bit. Something like this is fine. And now this is a pro tip. You select all of your rig, go to position, add key, rotation, add key. You can also do scale, add key if you want. So this is going to make sure that all of the rig is keyframed. Why is this important? Because you want to make sure that everything stays exactly the same. This will save you a lot of headache in the future, trust me. Because if you create a second animation, let's say you are animating something that is not being animated or keyframed in this idle animation, you're going to override it. It's going to make a lot of problems and you would have no idea why it is happening. So from now on, for every animation at the beginning and at the end, make sure that all of the rigs have their transform keyframed. This is going to save you a lot of headache. Trust me. Now I'll hit pause recording and let's move ahead in time. Maybe like 2 seconds. I would record again. I'm not gonna animate the legs. I'm just going to animate the spine a little bit. Then maybe a little bit of the arms, a little bit like this. Because this is the ideal animation, I can do whatever I want. And then maybe a little bit of the torso, little bit on the head, and there we go. Now if you unpause and hit play, you can see it looks good. Now you select the first keyframe, copy it, Control C, and then move to 4, I believe, 240, hit paste, and now we have created a looping animation. We can hit play and you can see it is looking good. I'll go to the game view and you can see that it looks good, really good. Next, I want to show you how to animate the eyes as well. So make sure that you are somewhere around here. Let's hit record, select just the eyes, and then add a keyframe for the scale. Okay, only the scale is enough. Then you move a little bit forward and then you press R on the keyboard and the scale is Y. So we need to animate the scale Y to 0 and then copy this first keyframe and then paste it somewhere like this. And now if we hit play, you can see that the eyes blink. Now we can select all of these 3 keyframes and put one here as well. Now I'll stop recording, I'll go to the game view and then hit play, and now you can see the idle animation is looking good and it is looping perfectly. And because all of the bones are keyframed in the beginning and at the end, there won't be any visual glitches later down the line once we create more animations. So there we go, we have created a very good idle animation. And that is how you do it. So let's create another animation. Click on player idle and then create a new clip. Let's call this player run. There we go, we are back to the default pose. Now for an animation, I recommend having a reference image. You can Google it up, just Google run animation and go to Google images. You'll see a lot of side scroller run animation references. I'm not allowed to show them on YouTube due to copyright reasons, but I have them in my side monitor so that I can use this as a reference, and I'm going to animate it based on that. So I'll hit record, I'll go here. So let's start by moving the right leg like this. There we go. For the arms, let's move it, and there is a little bit of bending, something like this. There we go. Maybe this arm is more like this. There we go, this is the first frame. Let's move ahead and then create the next frame of the animation. It doesn't have to be perfect, okay? We are learning. I am also learning. Move this one. And this is why having the hip is so useful. You can select the hip and then move the entire thing down. So right now you can see we are making this kind of movement, and having the hip has helped a lot. I forgot to animate this part of the leg here. There you go. Let's move ahead and create the next frame. And it's sort of like this. The third frame, this area comes like this. This one gets flattened out, and this part gets also flattened out. And then we animate the hip. Move it like this so that the leg stands upright. And this is why having the hip is so good, right? So now you have really smooth animation. Next up, we have the right leg, and the left leg goes up, something like that. And then the right arm comes like this, and the left arm goes back, and this part comes like this. Also, hip, move it down. Great. Next one is for the right leg to be stretched maximum. Left, this thing could also be placed like this. There we go. This one could be here. Maybe move it a little bit up and then move it like this. Left arm should go like this. And just to make it a lot more visually appealing, I'm just gonna move it here. Okay. The next one, everything should be in the air. So we have this, we have this. We need to rotate this, we need to rotate this. Okay, the entire character will be on air, and this part goes forward, this part moves backward. Maybe the arms comes like this. Really cool. And just to make it a lot more visually appealing, I'm just gonna move it here. I might also move the leg a little bit like this, then animate the hips, move it a little bit down so that it's on the air. Perfect. And the final frame is to move it like this, rotate it, and then make sure that this leg is grounded. I know it doesn't make a lot of sense, but it will. Okay, so now if we hit play, it looks terrible. This is how animations are made. And now we need to animate it for the other side as well. So move it like this, move it like this. We need a left leg here, right leg like this. Really cool. Then move the hip. The left leg should be like straight, almost straight. The right leg should be like this. Left arm should be like this. And the right arm should be, left arm should be straight, and the right arm should be like this. So it comes along naturally. Left arm should be like this. Right should be like this. Left should be like this. Right should be like this. Then select the hip and then move it up. Perhaps even move this leg a little bit. We need to straighten the left leg. Maximize this thing for the right leg. The left arm should be like this, and the right arm should be a little bit bended. The left leg should be in the air like this. The right leg should also be like this. Perhaps it's a little bit more down. Yeah, something like this. And the left arm is like this. The right arm should be like this. That's great. And then finally, the final pose should be this one, and I'll paste it here. Make sure to select all of the hips, add a key, add a key, add a key. Then let me delete this final one, copy and paste it here. And now you can see there's a little bit of jerking going on. Let's actually select all of them, right click both tangents linear. And now it's all a matter of fine-tuning this animation. So you can see here, I believe you can move it like this, maybe move it a little bit like this, so it is not penetrating that much. And on here, maybe here like this. There we go. So a little bit is fine. Here, let's go to the hip, move it a lot more down so there is less of a jerk. And here, somewhere along here, I would recommend moving this like this. And in this position, I will go to the hip, move it a lot more up. So something like, now I don't think this one is necessary, and this one can go a lot more down. So now if we hit play, something is weird, right? Let's set this to free smooth, and let's set this to free smooth. Let's see what happens. There's a bit of a weird thing going on. Let's set both of them to linear. There's a little bit of jumping going on up and up. This one here, this is the problem. So here you can see the hip position, and here the hip position are the same. I don't think there is a need to move down that much. All right, now we can set both of these to linear, and it still needs some fine tweaking, right? Let's set this one to linear as well. Maybe this one should be clamped auto, and this one should be clamped auto as well. And there we have it. We have a run animation, sort of okay. It's not the best run animation in the world, but it's okay. I am not the best at animation, but you can do it yourself, right? And the most important thing is it takes time. It really takes a lot more time than you think. It's not going to be a 10-minute video or a 10-minute fix. You need to spend a lot of time to fine-tune it, alright? And this is what a lot of people don't show. In the next one, we are going to be creating a very simple 2D template. Let's get started. That is our character animated and ready to move. In the final video, we'll bring everything together. adding movement controls, setting up the animator, using Unity's input system, and turning it into a full template you can reuse in your own games. Animation is never perfect on the first try, and I hope this video showed you the reality behind the process. See you in the next video. Take care. I love you.